Hey there everyone, it's time for another part of Pokémon Emeralds. And today, we're going to take on the mystery trainer that is in here. Well, not so much a mystery trainer if you have even a slightest inkling of the game. But, yes, it is Steven, the champion in Ruby and Sapphire. So I've got the gang up to level 85. We have Sylvanas, Grass Dragon. Substitute Leaf Blade, Leech Seed, Dragon Claw. I think everybody's moveset apart from Lunaturn's is the same. Kakarov with Amnesia, Explosion, Earthquake, Flamethrower. Lagoon with Belly Drum, Shadow Ball, Brick Break, Extreme Speed. Eclipse, Cosmic Power, Psychic, Ice Beam, Baton Pass. I changed this up because, I mean, Lunaturn doesn't do that much damage anyway. She's more of just a wall. So, with the Cosmic Power and the Baton Pass and the leftovers, her job is just to tank stuff and then pass it to somebody else if she's in a bad situation or I need a better type matchup. We've got Koella, our Relicanth, Rock Blast, Earthquake, Double Edge, Ancient Power. I can't remember if it had Ancient Rock Blast last time, but I made it similar to Triple Kick, where it gets stronger with each hit, starting at 35, 45, and then 55 power. With the Choice Band and Rock Head. And then we've got Tiamat, our Salamence, who I changed from Dragon Flying to Dragon Fire. Just because I feel like it fits Salamence more than, like, being a flying type, even though there's, like, you know, it's got the giant wings and, like, Bagon's dream is to be able to fly one day, but, like, I don't know, I just feel like Dragon Fire is just better for Salamence. And also because I just didn't like the 4x weakness to ice I had on two things, mainly. But, I mean, it led to a lot of fire moves leveling up anyway. As you can see, it's got a Hydro Pump and not Fire Blast. I also changed up his moveset to be a Dragon Dancer now instead of like a mixed attacker. Because when I was training him up, he just wasn't doing enough. So I've given him Dragon Dance instead now. Aerial Ace for... Well, it used to be Stab, it isn't anymore. Earthquake's just powerful in the Hydro Pump for water coverage, because I do not have that. He has the Lumberry, just in case someone tries to status him as I'm trying to set up. Choice Band on Koella for an extra bit of power. Leftovers for Eclipse to stay in the fight. Shell Bell on the Goon, because of Belly Drum. Like, I cut half my HP to get max attack, and then I can use the Shell Bell to get some HP back. Give a little bit of staying power, because it might come in handy, you never know. Quick Claw on Kakarov, because as you can see, he's slow as balls. And it'd be very funny if he just decided to go first and kill something that was about to kill him. And then the Citrus Berry on Sylvanas, just because of Substitute. Gives him a little bit of extra staying power as he's using them. So I have changed Steven's team. It's pretty different. And I'm kind of scared, so... Because he starts at level 90 and just goes up from there. But we're going to get into it. Hopefully we'll win. If not, then I don't know. I guess I'll just die, I guess. Oh, wow, Hatsu. I'm amazed you know where to find me. Do you maybe think of me just a rock maniac? No, that can't be right. We battled alongside each other at the Sootopolis Space Center. You should have a very good idea of how good I am. Okay, if you're going to mount a serious challenge, expect the worst. Alright, Steven, bring it on. Steven would like to battle, and he leads with a Fortress. I'm sure anyone who knows anything about Fortress knows what this thing's going to do. It's got two options. Well, not as in the move pool, but... And it used one of the options that I didn't think it was going to use. Okay, then. There's one of them. So yeah, this thing is just like completely support based. It's got reflect, light screen, spikes, and a final move, explosion. So yeah, that leech seed was a complete waste, considering it missed the first time. So I didn't even get any healing from that. Right, who's this next one? Deoxys. Yep. Yeah, okay. Level 100. So, this is his ace. I gave him Deoxys based on the facts of Pokemon Masters, where Signasuit Steven's got Deoxys. So, even though it looks like normal form Deoxys in the battle, it is actually speed form right now. A little interesting fact about Deoxys in the old days that people might not know is Deoxys' form actually was based on the game it was in. So in Ruby and Sapphire, it would be in its normal form. In Emerald, it's in its speed form. In Fire Red, it's in attack form. And in Leaf Green, it's in defense form. So as it is right now in its speed form, it's really, really fast. And it's got like middling offenses. But I do remember I gave this thing Ice Beam. So, I guess Eclipse and go from there. And in the later games, you can just like switch Deoxys' forms with a meteorite. Yeah, speed boost, which is a bit redundant because like it's like already like the fastest thing in the game. I didn't buy any healing items. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, oh, oh! I'm in danger. Oh my god! I actually can't believe I did that. Yeah, I was farming money off screen, and I haven't played like for like a week because I've been playing Tokyo Mirage Sessions. Yeah, that's what happens when you go right into it after not playing for so long. Oh my god. I think I've got like 100k in money, and I just... Oh my god. I give it Substitute, really? So what's it got? Substitute, Superpower, Ice Beam... It's gonna be Psycho Boost, right? Psycho Boost or Psychic? Oh, don't tell me I gave it Baton Pass. Passing those speed boosts and... Oh, well, actually, no. If I did give it Baton Pass, it wouldn't be that bad, because... Well, yeah, it would be passing some speed... It's a 10% chance. I didn't change Ice Beam 3's chance. I changed Blizzard's. Blizzard is 30%. Ice Beam is still 10. Or at least it should be. I might have changed it to 20%, but... I don't think I did. But yeah, Deoxys Baton Pass and stuff wouldn't be that bad, because... Well, yeah, it would be passing Speed Boost and a Substitute. It's also going to be passing those Attack and Defense lowers from Superpower. Which is fine by me, especially if he'd go to one of his other Pokemon. But yeah. As you can see, like, Deoxys is... I was going to say, as you can see, Deoxys isn't, in its speed form, isn't that powerful, but... yeah, things can change if it gets a crit. Yeah, Ice Beam's still not weakened. Because it's special. I should be able to tank with Coella, actually. Oh yeah, there's a layer of spikes off. Yeah, let's go Rock Blast. Rock Blast can go beyond subs. Well, not beyond subs, but it can kill a sub and then keep going afterwards. get another hit on. That was a lot of damage. Right, what do you got? Patea Berry! Oh, that's actually bad. Oh, I don't like that, because that's going to kill me now. I'm about to say who's got the best special defense, but I already know it's Lunaturn. Oh, after Lunaturn's got the best. Right, 136, 170. My god. Krikarov, I guess. Yeah, and the spikes as well. Oh, you bitch! Right, amnesia. Nice, okay, right. Gonna say, I hope he goes for like ice beam or superpower. Or substitute is fine. Literally anything except psychic. Get that amnesia going. I can't remember if I changed superpower from being a contact move or not. I honestly can't remember. Oh yeah, and you might have noticed that Steven's got the gym leader battle theme instead of the rival one. Yeah, I just feel like this is better. I originally had it as the champion theme. But, so there's the weird thing with the music is that you can't change the music itself. You can only change the trainer class. So, because it said... So, it said Leader Steven at the beginning. I had to change him to a gym leader. When I changed him to champion, originally, that was fine. But it did a cut-in of Wallace before the fight. And the arena is Wallace's arena in the league. So, yeah, it broke the immersion a little bit. And normally you fight him inside a cave, not this, just a standard, like, building type area. But yeah, this, the gym leader battle theme is my favourite theme in the game, which is why I selected it. It's also a bit more fitting. Ooh, nice, Quick Claw. It's also a bit more fitting than the rival theme for Steven, I think. Ooh, goddamn, that's a lot of damage. Only level 85 as well. Like, yeah, I like Camerupt already, but, yeah, I've got no healing items, what am I on about? But I've been, like, really surprised with how good he's been. Like, I know I've given him, like, the mega stats, or 50% of them, but, like, even before I did all that stupid stuff, like, Camerupt has been pretty good. Right, okay, so there's Deoxys down, that's his strongest one. Next is Metagross with Intimidate, because of course I had to do that. So I know this Metagross is banded. And the question is, what is it going to lock itself into? Because I'm on so low HP, it could go for anything since it sees a kill. So, like, I give it Meteor Mash, I give it Earthquake, probably, like, Rock Slide, and... Oh, yeah, I know it's another move. I'll go with Sylvanas, just in case it does go for Earthquake. Try and, like, tank it, even though... Yeah, okay. Even though his defenses are absolute jank, yeah. Citrus Berries, okay. Sub's not gonna help me, it's just gonna go down in one hit. Leech Seed it then. At least get something off on it. Because I don't think I'll survive this? No. Which is fine. Right, switch into your mat. Get Intimidate off on it because it doesn't have Clear Body. So I'll at least neuter it a little bit. The reason I didn't switch to Salamence straight away is because Earthquake and Rock Slide were very real options for it. And, yeah, Tiamat being a fire type now would not go well. Alright, let me send in the Goon. Hopefully, with his HP and defenses and the Intimidate, he'll be able to tank. Alright, let me X-Defend. My only X-Defend. See how that goes. Obviously, I'm not gonna be able to Belly Drum, but... Oh, that is a lot better, though. That is a lot better. Can't believe I didn't buy any fucking healing items. So Shadow Ball would actually be better because I fixed Shadow Ball to make it lower defense instead of special defense. Ooh, a crit, nice, not bad. Yeah, I fixed Shadow Ball to make it lower defense instead of special defense because it's physical in this game. Right, okay. Can't Belly Drum, but I will X Attack. Oh! Yeah, I forgot he's, he heals. But that's fine. That's fine, I can work with this. I keep forgetting that Steel was, oh, nice, the defense drop. I keep forgetting that Steel was resistant to Ghost and Dark before Gen 6. Oh, he's out. Ow. Oh, yeah, so something weird with Struggle is I upped the power of Struggle to, like, 200. Just to make it, like, really a really powerful, like, last resort option. And for some reason, it's so weak. Like, everything that's used it does one damage. And I don't know why. But I'm absolutely going to take advantage of this. Watch him get, like, a mega crit now and kill me. Okay. Is this it? Are we going to, Are we just going to Belly Drum with the Goon and sweep? Because that would be very funny. But yeah, it must be some, like, internal code with Struggle that messes up if you try and change the power of it. Right, so three left. Mawile, okay. Yeah, I made Mawile part fighting. I also gave it Focus Punch for some reason. Oh, wait, did I make it Sub Punch? I probably did. Yeah, Morwell's actually, like, quite tanky as well because of the mega stuff, the mega stats. But it wasn't enough for a plus 6 The Goon. Nice HP recovery there. Next is Caesar. Yeah, I gave it, like, actually mostly Steel types. Did I give this thing Quick Attack? I think I did not. Okay. Yeah, I gave him a, like, actual, like, proper Steel team instead of just whatever the fuck his team was before. Ooh, Swords Dance. Oh wait, did I give it a Salakberry? I think I did. I did. Ooh. Oh, is it going to be faster than me now? Even at plus 6, I don't know if Extreme Speed will actually kill. Fuck it, Weeball. Oh, yes. Healing. I keep forgetting about that somehow. In more ways than one. Oh well, it's just healing for me. Because of the shell bow. Give me that back, thank you very much. Hey, more HP for me, I don't care. Waste all your full restores, Steven. Better on Caesar than your fucking last one. Which I absolutely 100% remember. And I'm scared of. Oh, good to know I was just low rolling the last two times, but okay. Oh well, heal back up. And then next is Jirachi! Yes, this is his second ace next to Deoxys. So yeah, it's just Jirachi, mythical, steel type. I just thought it'd be fitting to give to Steven. Oh, wait a minute, I made this a fucking stall set, I think. What was it? Wish Protect, Psychic, Thunderbolt, something like that. Hopefully a plus 6 Shadow Ball will take it out, but there is the level difference to contend with. Yep. That's fine. I should be able to tank whatever it does. Fire Punch, okay. Oh, I was hoping for a bend then to get the Guts boost, but... it wouldn't have mattered anyway. Okay, right there. There we go. That goes, there goes Jirachi. And there goes Steven, actually. That was his last mon. Ooh, that's a lot of experience. You. I had no idea you'd become so strong. And I got a lot of money for winning. Come to think of it, ever since our past first crossed in Granite Cave in Dooford, I had this feeling. I thought that you would eventually become the champion. My predictions usually come true. And where will you go from here? Southern Island, I think. Even I couldn't tell you that. Alright, cool. And yeah, that's it. I don't believe you can refight Steven. I think it's a one-time only type deal. I might possibly be mistaken, but I don't think you can fight him again. So, yeah, that wasn't too bad, actually. Everybody was able to do something in the fight. Sort of. I mean, Eclipse just came in and died. Which, to be fair, wasn't my fault. Fucking crits. But, yeah, everybody got a bit of action. Salamence, not so much. But, yeah, I'm proud of everybody. You did it, guys. So since I've only been going for a few minutes, I'm gonna tack on the second idea that I had for this part. And that is catching the remaining legendaries that I had to do a bit of fuckery to get. So if you... I'm gonna need to give Sceptile another berry. Even though it's only 30 HP, it's not, like, a massive deal or anything, but it's better than now. I'm probably not even going to be using him because of what I'm going to be doing, but just for the future. You know, all these shinies I've found, and I haven't had Perkerus yet. I mean, I know it's rarer, but, like, still, it'd be funny. Considering I have found 2 actual legit shinies in this. I can't remember if I actually said or not, because, like I mentioned before, it has been, like, a week since I last played. Yeah, this Mighty Yenna here, this is a legit shiny as well, along with the Raichu. So, yeah, that's a thing. And also found some more, like, fucking 2 Wingulls. This Linoone, which was, like, a first encounter thing. Like, what was I doing? I was going down from Fortree for some reason. And, yeah, first encounter was this shiny Linoone. I found this Crobat in Steven's area. And a Taylor, another Anorith, another Lunatone. So, yeah, I've found some more. So, right, I'm at Lily Cove. So, we're going to be catching some more legendaries. And, yeah, I'll bring Dusclops to tank. I've changed the catch rates of, like, all of them to 45 after the last, the last one with, like, you know, Regirock, Rayquaza, blah, blah, blah. Well, mainly because I went shiny hunting for these two. Shiny Latias, Shiny Latios in Altering Cave. And I was not prepared to put in the work for, like, a 3 catch rate. After friggin' Regirock and Registeel and Rayquaza. Was absolutely not in the mood for them. So, if you have all the stuff needed, you can go to Southern Island for the other Lati that you did not say was on TV. Naval Rock, which is for Ho-Oh and Lugia. Birth Island, which is for Deoxys. And Faraway Island, which is for Mew. Which I believe was Japan only. For Faraway Island, at least. Not entirely sure about the others, but... Well, no, I know Deoxys was distributed. Because It was this... Was it this one? It might have been... I might be thinking of something else, but I think it was like a cartridge that you'd like insert into your Game Boy to like download the item. But I can't remember. I might be thinking of one of the DS games. So, once you come to Southern Island, you will see this rock here. Interact with it. And the other Lati will show up. This one will not run away. It is level 50 and it is holding the Soul Dew. What the Soul Dew does is it increases Latias or Latios' special attack and special defense by 50%. At least it was like that until Gen 5, I want to say. It was incredibly busted, because it was basically just, like, a free Calm Mind. Like, a free permanent Calm Mind. And you still could Calm Mind to plus 6 as well. Making it, like, really, really, really busted. Because you got... A free choice specs boost, and then you were just really specially tanky as well. In the current games, it is just a 20% boost to Dragon and Psychic type moves. Oh yeah, I'm part fighting. Ouch. And yeah, the 100% chance to lower special attack for Mr. Ball, and then special defense for Luster Purge. Nice. So, there we go. There's Latias caught. And when you catch it, you'll be able to take the Soul Dew off of it. So there we go. There is one down, 4 to go. Okay, and now we are here at Naval Rock with some good Fire Red and Leaf Green music. And now some not so good music. So when you come here, there will be a ladder going down. And then you will get 2 choices. So you can either go this way, which is a dead end. Good job. I ain't already, like, gone the wrong way, have I? I very well might have done. Yeah, that's a dead end as well. Right, okay, right, here are your two choices. So you can either go up, or you can go down. If you go up, you'll be able to get Ho-Oh. If you go down, you can get Lugia. I'll go down first, I guess. You can get both of them. You don't need to worry about, like, only getting to pick one and not the other. So, yeah, it's a bit of a trek down. And just keep in mind that you're going to have to do the same to not only get back up, but also to get Ho-Oh as well. I did heal, right? Yes, I did. So, yeah, once you get down here, you'll see Lugia here, ready for the catching. And he's even got the Fire Red and Leaf Green battle theme for Legendaries, which is a nice touch. So, what is Lugia going to have this level? Obviously, Ice Beam. Yeah, Premier Ball as well. Ice Beam, probably Hydro Pump, maybe Aero Blast, I'm not sure. Yeah, there's Hydro Pump. Let me switch to Dusclops, just a tank. So I made Lugia Water Flying in this instead of Water Psychic, just because it's like the god of the seas or whatever. It makes sense for him to be a fucking water type. In contrast to her as well, being Fire Flying. Of course, it's got Recover. Son of a bitch. Didn't use it all this time. God damn it. But yeah, that's his moveset. Ice Beam, Hydro Pump, Rain Dance, Recover. Ugh, should have changed that. Oh, wait a minute. I have Taunt. I'm a genius. You fool. I think Taunt only works for 110 in this game though, so it's not that good. Cool. So I only used Recover twice, that's fine. Fine by me. It means it didn't piss me off too much. Okay, so when you get to the top, come to this area. It'll light it up and then it'll come fight you. And he's also level 70. Oh, goddamn, I didn't heal. Oh yeah, I gave him Drought as a potential ability. Drought and... So I don't remember the other one. Probably the same as Lugia. Ouch, Jesus Christ. Oh yeah, I made Ho-Oh more of a special attacker than a physical one. What is Lugia's other ability? Water Absorb, okay, so I'll probably give it Flash Fire. Yeah, I made Ho-Oh more of a special attacker and I made Lugia more of a... Well, I say more of a wall, it's like already a wall. I just made it a bit more specialized. Of course, you've got Recover. Thank you. There we go. Its feathers, which were in 7 colours depending on the angle at which they are struck by light, are thought to bring joy. It is said to live at the foot of a rainbow. Cool. Now what nickname him? And if you examine where you fought him, you will find a sacred ash. Which is a rather rare item. Usually you only get one of those in the game. So it fully revives and restores all fainted Pokémon. It only works on stuff that's fainted. So you can't just fully heal everything. And I can't fly here, okay. Oh, well, let's have a look at her. Oh, modest nature. No wonder he's doing so much damage. 206. Yeah. Yeah, I made him quite a bit faster as well. Well, is more of the offensive one. And now we are at Birth Island, which is eerily devoid of music. So when you arrive, you will see this black triangle in the middle. Click on it, and it will move. We have to do a little puzzle. So the idea is to get to the triangle in as few steps as possible. Which isn't too difficult. I might have messed up already, though. Yeah. That's fine. So, yep. And then when it reaches this part, we will encounter Deoxys, who, as I stated before, is currently in his speed form. Even though it looks like he's in his normal one. So he's only level 30, so be careful not to accidentally kill him. Yes, his premieres on him. Definitely be very careful if you're fighting him in Fire Red in his attack form, because there is the very real possibility that he can just kill you, even though he's only level 30. Speed and defense and, well, you can't even fight him in his normal form, because Birth Island wasn't in Ruby and Sapphire, at least not as far as I'm aware. But his other forms shouldn't be a challenge, but definitely be careful you don't get killed by his attack form. Okay, cool, that was easy. Also, definitely bring a false swiper for these, because naturally level 30 is not very high, and Deoxys has got really bad HP. What an oddly shaped island, eh? You want to return to Lily Cove? Yeah. And finally, we're at Faraway Island. So you can go over here, which is the wrong way. All that's here is a sign. The writing is fading as if it was written a long time ago. Birth, sixth day. If any human sets foot here again, let it be a kind-hearted person. With that hope, I depart. So yeah, I think this is like the original island where Mew was supposed to be in the movie, but I'm not 100% sure. But we do get the really nice abandoned ship theme again. So when you step in here, you'll be in a little forest type place. You'll see Mew, and he'll hide in the grass, and every so often you can see him moving around. And basically your job is to find him, corner him. And when you do, you won't be able to move. And when you get to that point, you'll get Mew with a little remix of the legendary battle theme in Fire Red Leaf Green. Now, I don't think Mew is terribly difficult to get. It is level 30 like Deoxys is, but... Oh, actually, no, yeah, you do want to be a bit careful because it might have Transform. Or you can just catch it on the first ball. Like, it's not hard. It's just piss easy. And Mew is said to possess the genes of all Pokémon. It is capable of making itself invisible at will, so it entirely avoids notice, even if it approaches people. And there we go! Oh yeah, Deoxys is still here. Oh yeah, now you can see its speed form. As you can see, its stats are middling, apart from its speed, which is very, very high. Knock Off, Pursuit, Psychic, Nightshade. I don't think I'd change any of those. And then Mew with Synchronize. Mew's got base 100 in all stats. I don't think I changed it. So yeah, it's got Transform. And also Metronome. So you do want to be a bit careful, because Metronome could turn into a move that kills itself, like Memento, Explosion, or Self-Destruct. Or a recoil move as well, which... obviously, if you've already got it at 1 HP with False Swipe, will kill it instantly. And then Transform, obviously, it turns into one of your Pokémon, so it could just end up killing you with your own stuff. So... it might be a good idea to make False Swipe the only offensive move on whatever your False Swiper is, just so it can't kill you. But I can't remember if it's this game or later ones, but when Mew transforms, I think it copies the catch rate of whatever it transforms into. So if you're bringing something with a low catch rate, definitely do not lead it or keep it in as a tank. You bring something like a Pidgey, or, well, it's Emerald, so there won't be a Pidgey. Like something like a Zigzagoon or a Poochyena, and have it transform into that, you could just make it, like, really easy to catch. Just be aware, though, that when it does use Transform, while it does copy your moves, it only gets 5 PP for all of them. So, it's a bit of a war with time in that regard, if you're not able to have much luck. Captain Brian, he can be so maddeningly fickle. Do you want to return to Little Cove? Where did that come from? Why did he just start complaining about his boss? Oh well. But yeah, that is all of the event legendaries now. We are done with those. So the next time will be us going to the Battle Frontier. And having quite a bit of fuckery with that. Let me grab our team. Just to prepare for that. Kakarov. The Goon. Well, and then Eclipse. Wonderful. So, that's going to do it for this part. And for the next one, yeah, it's going to be the Battle Frontier, because aside from Gym Leader rematches, which are quite rare, I've only got Lyzer and Tate right now. Yeah, there's not much else to do in the game now. Just getting the silver and gold symbols, which is probably going to be a big chore. But I'll do my best. I'll get at least the silver symbols, apart from maybe from the palace. I'll explain all the facilities in the next part, but yeah, the battle palace is definitely something. But yeah, I'd like to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers for watching, everybody.